consultants, amongst the graduate member of the ICU. Today, we'll be talking about coastal defences and their impact on sediment transport. Now, we all know that coastal structures are used in preventing coastal erosion and localised flooding. And there are several different types of structures out there. You have gabions, seawalls, groins, revetments, breakwaters, and they all have different roles and different effects. While sediment transport, on the other hand, not only provides a habitat for fish and vegetation, is also what our beaches are made of. So what I have here is a wave tank that represents each and every section of coastline, and without any man-made structures. And inside it, I have three different types of sediment, and they differ based on weight. Blue is the lightest, green slightly heavier, and black is the heaviest. Now, as you introduce waves into the system, the sediment will distribute itself across the base of the tank, but slowly but surely, it will start to degrade. If I introduce an offshore breakwater, now this kind of structure is used in dissipating wave energy offshore. Now the sediment is split between the upstream and the downstream side of the breakwater. The sediment upstream will be transported by the waves to the taller structure, will form a small mound, and then the lightest particles, small amounts, will be lifted and transported over. And because the structure is submerged, some of the energy is still transported to the coastline, but the sediment block downstream is still distributed quite evenly, but slowly it will spread out and move beyond the tank. If I remove the breakwater, introduce a slow seawall. With a recurved crown wall. Now this kind of structure instead is used right against the coastline to prevent overtopping and limit localized flooding, but by reflecting the wave energy back into the sea. Now the sediment will be transported again to the taller structure close to the coastline, but because you have large amounts of wave reflection, a much larger mound will form. A much larger mound will form because there's a zone of high velocity on the outside and a zone of low velocity at the center. This rotating mound is similar to a sausage roll. Will lead to localized erosion, total erosion of the structure, which can lead to structural failure, and also impact incoming waves. So the purpose of this model is to bring attention to the fact that the impact of coastal structures on sediment transport should be considered and should be fully understood before implementation.